The worst feeling is when you're talking and you know you're about to cry and just hope your voice isn't showing it.
Just thought I'd let you know that I'm still alive, but I'm barely breathing.
I'm laughing because I had no fucking reason to die. Reason whatsoever to die. Dumbest fucking of all time. You're lost, you fucking morons. What the fuck? Why did I die? Why did I die? I'm telling him the whole way through the episode. This is it. This is unpacked, this, shall we? I'm telling him the whole way through the last several episodes, you have to be there, you're Niklas, you have to be there for hope. Well, you know, and then now he's dying, but I'm not going to be there for hope.
It's been a glorious ride, Niklas.
I hate when people ask me, why are you so quiet? Because I am. That's how I function. I don't ask you, why are you so noisy? Why do you talk so much? It's rude.
You ever feel like no one understands you? Like every day is a constant fight against a feeling that you don't even understand.
I want to love you, but you have to understand that it's hard. You see, love is a perfect picture with a fairy tale ending and everything wrapped in a perfect little bow. I've seen what happens behind closed doors, yelling and fighting and being told I will never be good enough. It will never matter how many times you tell me you love me for me, I will always believe you have ulterior motives, and it has nothing to do with you, and it sucks this is what I'm used to. But I've been ignored and told that any other girl would, so why won't you? Loving may come easy to you, but I don't know if it's something I can do. You are perfect and kind and show me love at every other corner, but in the back of my head there is always that voice that says you long for more, and why wouldn't you?
Klaus Mikkelsen being a mood part 1.
I could never get my head far enough up my own arse.
Oh bloody hell.
Absolutely not.
Nonsense, I love people.
You don't have to hurt anybody.
Oh come on, love.
Of course I do.
Only this time I intend to enjoy it more.
Put it out.
You are supposed to be dead. Sheep.
If you continue to defy me, your lives will be reduced to an unending sequence of agonizing torture.
This family makes me want to murder people.
We stopped leaving cookies and milk out for Santa. The Tooth Fairy has no reason to come anymore because we've lost all of our teeth. The Easter Bunny doesn't come because we're too old for that stuff. And the leprechauns who turned our toilets green don't prank us anymore. Why didn't we listen to our parents when they told us to stop growing up? I wish we could still play with our food without being told, where are your manners? Or climb a tree and then scream for help down because we got stuck. I wish that begging to go to the park was still a daily thing. I wish that it was still cute when we can't pronounce a word right. I wish that our parents still had the energy to run around in the backyard with us when they get home from work. I wish we weren't focused on our weight or our height. I wish we didn't have to choose between eating when we're hungry or waiting a few more hours because we ate the day before. I wish we didn't have to feel like we won't fit in for being ourselves. I wish we didn't have the constant struggle of choosing between an A on a test or our mental health. I wish so many things, but I wish that most of all, that we would have listened to our parents when they told us to stop growing up.
I'm trying, but all these voices in my head get loud. I wish that I could shut them out.
Kids have two parents. Why the mom the only one that's gotta make the sacrifices?
No, I'm hard to deal with, but I'm sorry, don't leave me. I need you here with me.
It's Meredith. The girl with the bomb is Meredith.
Okay, when are you gonna stop suggesting that I'm suicidal?
When you start acting like somebody that wants to be alive.
Christina, you're still my person. Even when I know.
Of course I will be fine. I'm always fine, don't you know that?
Look to me.
I make no apologies for how I chose to repair what you broke. You don't get to call me a whore.
It's good to be scared. It means you still have something to loot.
Derek is dead.
How about you take a minute to think about the person, the talent, the life that we lost?
You know what to do already. If you didn't, you wouldn't be in so much pain.
I can't live without you. I don't want to live without you.